Morning. So today we will see the experiment number 3, measurement of resistance using Wheatstone's bridge. So this is the basic circuit diagram of the Wheatstone's bridge. So in this Wheatstone's bridge, we will be having the 4 arms here, arm 1, arm 2, 3 and 4. In each arm, we are going to be connecting one resistance here. So this bridge is going to be excited by using the voltage source E. So here for this bridge, we are going to be providing the DC voltage of 5 volts. So before starting the operation, make the switch to be open. So then if you close the switch SW1, then this voltage E is going to be applied to the bridge. So due to this voltage, the current I1, I2, I3 and I4 will be flowing in the 4 arms here. So between the two points C and D, we are going to be connecting one galvanometer, which is used for measuring the current between the points C and D. So if you observe the scale of the galvanometer, at the center will be having the 0, and based upon the direction of current, the pointer will be moving towards the right side or towards the left side. So it indicates the direction of the current as well as the magnitude of the current also. So for measuring the value of the resistance, so generally the unknown resistance is going to be connected in the 4th arm. So here R4 or RX, this is called as the unknown resistance. So we have to measure the value of this unknown resistance. So for measuring this value of unknown resistance, we have to bring the bridge to the balanced condition. So here we can bring the bridge to the balanced condition by performing two ways here. So one is, make the voltage at point C is equal to the voltage at point D. Voltage at point C is equal to voltage at point D. Or if there is no current is flowing across the galvanometer, the pointer will be indicating the 0 on the scale. So the pointer in the galvanometer will indicate 0 when there is no current flowing in the galvanometer, or when the voltage at point C is equal to voltage at point D. So we can obtain the first condition when I1 R1 is equal to I2 R2, when the drop across R1 is equal to drop across R2, or when the drop across R3 is equal to drop across R4, I3 R3 is equal to I4 R4. So in these two conditions, we can obtain the first condition, EC is equal to ED. The voltage at point C is equal to voltage at point D. So if you want to obtain no current across the galvanometer, then I1 should be equal to I3, I2 should be equal to I4. So when I1 is equal to I3, no current is flowing across the galvanometer. So similarly, when I2 is equal to I4, no current is flowing across the galvanometer. So here, when I1 is equal to I3, then R1 and R3 both are in series here. So the applied voltage is E. So E by R1 plus R3. So in the same way, I2 is equal to I4, that is equal to applied voltage E by, so these two resistors are in series, R2 plus R4. Okay? So you substitute these values in the first equation, that is I1 R1 is equal to I2 R2, or we can take I3 R3 is equal to I4 R4. So if you take the first equation, I1 means E by R1 plus R3 into R1 is equal to I2 E by R2 plus R4 into R2. So if we simplify this equation, we will be getting R4 or Rx is equal to R2 R3 by R1. So this is called as a bridge balanced equation. So by using this equation, we can find out the value of the unknown resistance Rx. Okay. So while we are going to be performing the practical way of measuring the resistance, any one arm should contain the variable resistance. So in this case, in arm 1, we are going to be keeping the variable resistance. So by varying this resistance R1, we have to make the bridge to be in the balanced condition. That is, we have to bring the pointer in the galvanometer to 0. By varying R1, we have to bring the pointer in the galvanometer to 0. So after getting the pointer at a 0 position, we can use this equation. Rx is equal to R2 R3 by R1. We can find out the value of the unknown resistance Rx. So next we will see the practical way of measuring the value of the resistance Rx.
Okay, now we will practically implement the Wheatstone bridge circuit here. So the components required for this Wheatstone bridge experiment is one breadboard, and we are taking three resistors, one decayed resistance box, one power supply, and a multimeter. In the place of the galvanometer, we are placing the multimeter. So first of all, switch on the power supply. So by varying the coarse knob, you get the voltage as 4 volts. You keep the voltage below 5 volts only. Now I am keeping the voltage as 4.1 volt here. Okay, and you know the connections in the breadboard here. So here all the vertical lines are going to be shorted here. At the bottom, all the horizontal lines will be shorted. Okay, so based upon this, we are going to be connecting the resistors in the form of a Wheatstone bridge. So this is arm 1, arm 2, arm 3, and in arm 4 we are going to be connecting the decayed resistance box here. Okay, in arm 1 we are keeping the resistance as 150 ohms. In arm 2, 220 ohms. In arm 3 also 150 ohms. Now we are going to be finding the value of the resistance in the arm 4. Okay, so first of all, before applying the bridge balanced equation, that is Rx is equal to, that is R1 into Rx is equal to R2 R3, then Rx is equal to R2 R3 by R1. So before using that equation, first of all we have to bring the bridge to the balanced condition. Okay, so here this is the decayed resistance box here. So in this decayed resistance box, this is the decayed resistance box here. So by using this box, we can get the required amount of resistances here. So this is the range of resistances, 0 ohms to 100 ohms, and this is 0 to 1k, 0 to 10k, 0 to 100k, and 0 to 1000k. So this is from 0 to last value into 10, 100 ohms. Okay, so in order to, that is here in this case, we are keeping all the values at 0 ohms only. All the points are indicating 0 only. So 0 plus 0 plus 0 plus 0 plus 0. So the value is 0 ohms. So now this is 150 ohms into 0. That is 0 ohms. This is 150 into 220. That is the bridge is not in the balanced condition. This value into 0. 0 ohms. And that is equal to 150 into 220. The bridge is not in the balanced condition. So for that reason only, it is showing some value in the multimeter. Okay. So whenever the multimeter shows 0 volts, then only the bridge is in the balanced condition. Now we have to bring the bridge to the balanced condition. So the first arm 2 is 220 ohms, arm 3 is 150 ohms. Okay. So here arm 1 is 150 ohms. Then automatically we can say that arm 4 should also contain 220 ohms. Then only the bridge is in the balanced condition. So keep the value 220 ohms here. Now keep here 20. So 2 into 10, 20. Next keep it as, okay. So now it is 2 into 100, 200. All are in 0 only. So 20 ohms plus 200 plus 0 plus 0 plus 0. That is equal to 220 ohms here. So now from by using decayed resistance box, we are getting the value in arm 4 as 220 ohms here. Now the bridge is in the balanced condition. 150 ohms into 220 ohms. 150 ohms into 220 ohms. Arm 1, arm 4 contains 150, 220. Arm 2 and arm 3 contains 220 and 150 ohms. So then R1 into Rx is equal to R2 into R3. Bridge is in the balanced condition and the reading in the multimeter is 0 volts. So whenever we are getting 0 volts in the multimeter, the bridge is in the balanced condition. Then apply the bridge balanced equation.
Okay.
So in the breadboard, we are taking R1 as 150 ohms, R2 as 220 ohms, R3 as 150 ohms. We have to find out the value of Rx. So the product of opposite arm resistances is equal to the product of other opposite arm resistances. R1 into Rx is equal to R2 into R3. Rx is equal to R2 R3 by R1. Substitute the values here. 220 ohms into 150 ohms by R1, 150 ohms. So 150, 150 cancel. Rx is equal to 220 ohms. So here Rx is equal to 220 ohms. So that is the value which is obtained in the practical, in the Wheatstone bridge. You can verify the the same thing by using different resistors in the 4 ohms. You will be getting the different values. So finally, first of all, you have to make the bridge in the parameter condition, then only apply the bridge parameter condition. You will be getting the value of the unknown resistance Rx.